Hi, I'm Katherine Wilson Tucker, Cat for short, from Next Step Quilt Designs. When you piece your flying geese, do you get perfect rectangles? If your flying geese are askew like mine used to be, my trim down method that I'm going to show you will help you accurately piece four flying geese that have a finished width that is twice the finished height. For example, the flying geese I am making are finished 3 inches wide by 1.5 inches high with 1/4 inch seam allowances. To make these flying geese, first you need one large square that is cut 1.5 inches larger than the finished width. So this blue square has been cut 4.5 inches square, which is 3 inches plus 1.5 inches. Then you need the four small squares that are cut 1.25 inches larger than the finished height. These orange squares are cut 2.75 each, which is the 1.5 finished plus the 1.25. One way to remember these calculations is that the large square adds to the larger amount, i.e. 1.5 inches, and the four smaller squares adds the smaller amount, 1.25 inches. Okay, now we cut the one large square diagonally in half in both directions. So you have to line the ruler up with the corners. So now we have, we've cut it into four, and now we cut the four orange squares only in half. Okay, now I've laid out the pieces that I cut in the way the flying geese will look at the end. And what I do now is you take one blue one and the orange one, and you line them up so that the sides match and the corners. Okay, so now I'm just gonna sew the first. And then we're gonna chain piece the other three together. And you notice that I start right at the top. This'll come in handy for when you're pressing. Okay, now we've chain pieced all the triangles together and I'm going to press them. In most cases, you press the smaller triangle, which is orange in color, away from the center one. Then we just clip them apart. Okay, now we're going to sew the remaining triangles to the other side of the piece. So again, you line up the corner and the bottom and the side. Again, you press it generally away from the center blue one. Now we're going to trim down the four flying geese. Okay, now you can see that I put the 1.75 inch by 1/4 mark at the top of the V, and the 3.5 inch and the 2 inch marks all line up at the intersections between the blue and the orange. And we trim off the side and the top, flip it around, line up the 3.5 inch here, the 2 inch on the bottom. You see as well that these corner of the ruler is on that sewn line there. Trim off the side and off the top. Thank you for watching this tutorial. On my website, www.nextstepquiltdesigns.com, under the how-to section, there are printable instructions for the flying geese trim down method. Here are some quilt blocks that have the flying geese in them.